what we consider as alternative professions. I am a musician myself. I come from the background of music. So today, if anybody asks me, what do? I work for this music education company. I had quality for the country, but in the heart of heart, my core profession, I'm a musician. So people need to shift their mindset from considering these professions as alternate professions. Photography, videography, cinematography, music, all these, they come in the main profession stream. And just like Jasinda Ji was talking just 5 minutes back about how we cannot have all those many CAs and doctors and engineers. Everybody can't be going for the same profession, and everybody is not cut out for the same thing. And what is commendable is that the NEP has addressed all these diverse aspects. There is so much of focus which has been given in, on 21st century skills, communication, be it critical thinking, creativity, collaboration. And like Ms. Archana Mishra had mentioned, these are just the guidelines which are given, and the implementation, just like Rajulji was also asking, what would be the recommendation regarding the implementation? The implementation needs to completely happen from the end of the institutions. There needs to be a change in the mindset of the institution. Sensitization of the parents even need to come into the picture right now. If we need to ensure that the entire country is following the NEP 2020, the focus, I feel, is totally on experiential holistic learning. And that is what I got out of reading the entire material. And I feel it will definitely help the children, gain practical learnings for their life. I would like to begin by taking everybody to a few thousand kilometers away from here, the US, where the company Torrens, the one which I represented, which started from. We started from the US like 13 years back. And currently, we are in over 200 public schools in the US. And these are public schools. These are not even private schools. They are always cash strapped, and they have a lot of funding problem. But in spite of that, one thing we see is that all these children, they have a good laboratory. They have a lot of instruments. If a kid wants to go and learn a guitar or probably a keyboard, he doesn't have to wait for the other child to finish his playing to take the guitar. And that is what happens. We don't even see that in the premium institutions in our country. By the time one child finishes his playing and he comes to taking the guitar, the period is over and he has to rush back to his class. So that is where companies like us come into the picture. We are music education aggregators, and we provide an entire 360-degree solution. We provide music teachers, curriculum solution, equipment like 20, 30 guitars, 20, 30 keyboards, drums, etc. And I feel it is high time we value the contribution of music in the life, and in the well-being of humans. I think we need to streamline the whole idea of music in the learning curriculum. And just like how everybody is not cut out to being a CA or probably a doctor or any other profession, we need to allow aptitude some space here. We need to check the aptitude of the child and teach the child what he wants to actually learn. And I'm sure there are going to be many people who want to be musicians. In one of the previous sessions, Jasinder Ji, I think he was there, and Rajul also was here. We were speaking to a gentleman, Mr. Parush Arora. He happens to be the director of an institution in the UP. He took up music, he took up guitar playing in these lockdown days. And within 7 months, he became so proficient in guitar playing that he performed live only with a 7 month guitar experience for the New Year. And he also performed for a gig yesterday. So, and we are in touch with him, we are discussing with him regarding a few things. So the thing is that if a person, he himself said during the session that if it weren't, if he would have been given music education at during his early learning years, he would have been a musician today and not the director of an institute. And we all know a great amount of research has been done in music and how music directly impacts the cognitive development of children. One of the schools which I visited in central India, after giving the program to them, she had called us, the ma'am had called us after 4 months. I went to meet her, and she told me that, how there has been up to 100% reduction in classroom violence and the destruction of the material and the equipment which the school has. Otherwise, earlier they used to see that, you know, there are so many children, because children are very energetic, you know, and they need to channelize their energy somewhere. And sometimes, if the schools are not very strict, we see that there are breakages, furniture damage, electrical damage. There are fans which are bent out of shape in class, air conditioners which are broken and everything. And all this, you know, costs a lot of money. Redoing all this costs a lot of money. So introducing a program like music helps the children channelize that residual energy, you know, and that can be channelized in the right way. The child gets an opportunity to improve his memory, improve his brain skills. Einstein himself took up violin learning and piano learning so that it could augment his thinking process. He would sit with a piece of rock, which would be so big, on his rocking chair, and used to work out on theories and concepts. And he would visualize himself, you know, running behind beams of light. He would do a lot of crazy stuff like that. But all this when there would be music playing in the background. All this brings children to their, you know, to the in touch with the human side. And to introduce music at such a huge level in the country, following the NEP, there would be some kind of an expertise which is required. We need to accept the fact that there is a dearth of experienced instructors in the country, especially when it comes to teaching music. And like Archana ma'am, during her talk, she said that there would be huge costs for infrastructure. Now, that is where we come in. We are not just music teachers, like how I began. We are a music education solution provider. We provide a 360-degree solution for music. We provide teachers, curriculum, training, and equipment, just like I said, 20, 30 guitars, keyboards, so that every child gets an opportunity to spend time with that instrument, learning it. Yeah. So I feel that overall it needs to be a theory and application integrated program. And I think, given the stresses of the current times, where we are seeing bad situations around and children between the age group of 6 to 14 facing situations like depression and suicidal thinking, stuff which we had not even heard probably during the olden times, but everything which has just started rising. So I think music is definitely going to help the kids in this generation and, of course, in the times to come. Over to you, Rajulji. Thank you.
Thank you, Sevio, for mentioning how music can certainly, make the world better. And I completely agree. The example you gave of Paroshji, who said that if he would have got the opportunity to learn music, to get exposed, with his stream, so he would have he might have chosen a different kind of field, right? So thank you, Sevio. The time for the
Right.
questions. I would request all our
Thank you.
speakers. I'll present these questions if we can have your comments and perspective on this. Right. So a big thanks once again, Archana ma'am, Ravi ma'am, Manoj sir, N.K. Sharma sir, Jasminder sir, and Sevi for joining. Now, before I start presenting questions, I'll take a minute in explaining, what exactly we're doing at School Lalaji Solutions. And after that, immediately I'll start presenting questions. So I'll share my screen here. Some of you are already aware, that the School Lalaji, we are India's largest one-stop solution, platform for educational institutions. We are currently present in 42 cities, working with somewhere around 4,500 institutions. We help educational institutions in three ways. We help them in buying right thing from right people at right price. We also help them in selling their old, items like their old buses, generators, their furniture. No, we also help institutions in raising money, that may be in terms of loan or fee financing. Why there is a need, for a platform like School Lalaji Solutions? In India, we have tens of thousands of, companies which are offering some solutions to educational institutions, and many of those solutions are, unique in nature. And but the biggest challenge is, for education leaders and for those companies, that it's very difficult. It's very difficult, for education leaders to meet all those companies, to take, detail demo, for those products and things. So here we come, and we understand your school, we understand your interests, we understand your taste, and accordingly we talk to different companies, and we interact with them, and accordingly we filter and recommend, selected companies to you. We also do negotiation on behalf of educational institutions. These are the areas where we are working. We are helping in smart class procurement, uniform insurance, bus insurance, students insurance, diesel. It's a part of Delhi NCR. We are also supplying diesel, delivering diesel at the school doorstep, cheaper than the market price. Solar plant installation, we are helping institutions for language lab, security solutions, furniture, recruitment, music classrooms, healthcare, robotics, STEM, STEAM labs, career counseling, stationery, digital marketing, IT solutions, educational tour, generators, learning tools, and finance. And we take the guarantee that will at least save your 5 to 7%. That's kind of additional 5 to 7% revenue, for your school. And just one example, in 2019, we saved 2 crore 40 lakh rupees in bus insurance alone. These are some major highlights. So we did some 8 megawatt, solar installation, 3000 plus bus insurance, 400 plus smart classrooms, 2000 plus cameras, 350 plus training programs, 56 old buses we sold from one school to other, a uniform in 42 schools. By the end of 2021, we aim to reach out to 10,000 institutions. We need your support, your guidance, and your blessings. So thank you. With this, I straight away. Presenting questions. So I would request Archana ma'am, if I can present the first question to you.
Yes.
Thank you. Right. So this question has come from Ms. Megha Tyagi. She is a teacher with the TransLearn Academy Meerut. So Megha ji has asked, post NP implementation, who would be the regulator for educational institutions?
I think Megha, the regulation has to be self. Too much of regulation from outside would stifle the institutions. Depending on how much you are able to do, how much you are able to implement, how many resources you are able to garner, and I think regulation should come from within first. It should be a self-regulatory thing. Yes, largely the regulation will be in the hands of the authorities. Like there's the National Testing Agency, then there is the PARAK. Then so all those agencies have been put in, but they are seeing only a part of it. In totality, we have to see our own growth in terms of. Adaptation and go step by step, not try to bring in everything together and spoil the process. So that is what my take on it.
Right. Thank you, Archana ma'am. Ravi ma'am, I would request if you can take on this question. This has been asked by Ms. Pratima Rathod. Pratima ji is assistant teacher with the Navarachana Vidyani School. Pratima ji has asked, what are the schemes for developing ECCE at rural areas? If you can highlight those areas in national education policy, about ECCE.
Well, thank you for the question. NEP 2020 has definitely given a very good stress on early childhood learning. And this NEP is highlighting more on emphasizing the fact that if the foundation is strong, definitely the child is going to grow more confidently. Although in India, the primary education, the early education has been little ignored by the parents. Like during the COVID, the parents are not ready to entertain this online teaching. Saying that my child is very small and this network problem and this and that, not many issues, and they said ki no problem, ek saal bachcha hamara nahi bhi padega to koi baat nahi, kaun sa usko IAS officer banna hai. So this NEP 2020 is going to give a very good emphasis and trying to highlight the importance, that what is the importance of a foundation stone. If you really want to construct a very good, very strong building, so foundation need to be very strong. Thank you.
Absolutely. Thank you, Ravi ma'am. I'll come back to you. Manoj sir, I would request, if you can take on this question. I'm sure you know this question has been asked by Sapna Awasthi, ma'am. Sapna ji is a teacher with Sumitra, you know, modern school, Sitapur, Uttar Pradesh. Sapna ji has asked, you know, how we can make online study even better. Right, so that's a question for everyone.
Right. Thank you, Sapna, for such a nice question. Frankly speaking, online, everybody initially found it very difficult because of the fact we were never trained to be an online teacher. We've been so used to the paper pencil mode of teaching. So initially, everybody struggled. What I find right now is now teachers have become more smarter. They know how to use technology in terms of adaptation. They know how to merge PPTs. You have a vast resources of library available online. If you're smart enough to utilize it and make it interactive, I feel it's a visual medium. Like how we enjoy movies, we'll remember a scene or a dialogue eon years later also. So if you can use that to adapt or make changes, students will remember that point much better than any of them. I think that adaptation from technology has to be used. You have to be smart enough to highlight that point which you want to say it, maybe in terms of a visual or maybe in terms of a PPT or whatever modes you are using it. But that could be the best part for a student to understand. Thank you.
Thank you, Manoj sir. N.K. Sharma sir, I would request if we can take on this one. This has been asked by Ms. Neena Kapoor. Neena ji is principal with the AI International School, Noor Mahal, Jalandhar. The question is, in the present scenario, when there is a decline in moral values, will there be any specific focus on moral values and Vedas with the amalgamation of artificial intelligence? So if I try to simplify the question, N.K. Sharma sir, what would be your suggestions, how we can, you know, integrate, you know, values and, you know, the values learned from Vedas with the integration of technology? N.K. Sharma sir.
I heard he was called for a meeting somewhere, so maybe.
Okay. Jasminder sir, I would request, because we know that you know everything. So Jasminder sir, over to you.
Rajul, please, this is not the forum to pull my legs, please.
No, I'm not doing that. I can't even dare to do that. But we all know that, you know, you read so much, you know, meet with so many people, you understand things in that. You have that special talent we all need to learn from you, sir. Jasminder sir, I would request if you can comment on this particular question.
Okay, so can I take the liberty of adding to something for the Please. Previous question, which was answered by Professor Manoj. Online learning, if you really want it to be effective, you have to engage them. What I'm doing is just for you all to know, I am currently doing a pilot with 9 students from a school in Bina, which is MP in the Sagar district. And that city has got only 3 English medium schools. And I'm dealing with students of class 2. And I've realized that I have a session on alternate days from 1 to 2. And I've realized that they are there at 12:30. Because, you know, you get a message on your thing, so much so and so has joined. And the parents say that the kids love it. So why do they love it? Because it is not only teaching the syllabus or that part. We teach different parts. Right from, why did you not wear a sweater today? And the next day, everybody's wearing a sweater. Because kids at that age, you know, they don't want to do this, they don't want to do that, and they're at home. And they're so fed up of sitting at home, so they throw a lot of tantrums. So what we've seen is when you get into this engaging these people, online learning is better than normal learning is what I see. And what we need to do is to take their names at regular intervals. If you keep taking their names, they know there's something else, and not to put their videos off. Okay, kids are smart. Okay. Now coming on to this point, you were talking about Vedas and Upanishads, and you're talking about learning how to be a good human. You know, the whole thing is technology can bring in a lot of reading, right? Technology can bring in a lot of animated videos. Let me tell you one thing. Ramayana, Mahabharat, humne kabhi nahi padhi hai, lekin that serial actually made us understand what Ramayana is all about. Am I right? You know, we would never have gone and, you know, read that those epics. So what happens is, again, if I bring in that compassion will come when they understand the fellow citizens. Compassion and morality will come if they go and work somewhere, if they do social work, like I think somebody said, I think Professor Manoj said that in the US, if you have done some social work, you get goodie points. So if that is brought in, you see what happens is I am a regular, you know, I'm following Pakistan geopolitics, right? And I follow using videos, YouTube videos. You know what they talk about Indians? Ki agar ek family driver ko leke, if they are going out and if they're eating at a restaurant, the driver will sit on a different table in India. And in their place, that driver will eat from their plate. So we need to value professions. The moment we do that, all these things will come in. Vedas are already talking about it, right? But we have to bring that into actual life. We may not be able to teach the Vedas to the current generation, but using some or the other way of making them more compassionate, love the other. You know, we say that the whole world is one family, but actually we don't practice that. We're not practicing for our entire country also. Though diverse, it's a difficult thing. But if the Vedas were talking about that, I don't know, I mean, that entire slok that say some Vasudeva Kutam, right? So that is so important. If we Indians are made to understand, okay? And I don't think that is the work of the school or the educationist only. It is the work of the parents. They are the ones who bring in the difference. So we need to educate the parents. And there should be no difference. And you know, the when we talk about social structure or financial structure, they should all be brought in. So I don't think we need technology to do that. We need compassion. We need love to do that. And I'm sure if we bring in that much needed love, which is not there, all these things can be taken up. Yes, but an educated person can love better. I would know, that's all I will say. You read more, you love more. That's my answer to this.
Right. Thank you. Because he understands the value of love and the cost involved in the hate. So thank you, Sundar sir. You know, for that, I would request Sevio, you know, the last question for the day. Sevio, you know, you belong to this thing. This NEP has emphasized upon the co-curricular activities. You know, but how do you think it would be possible for, you know, all these schools, you know, in Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, or, you know, in far-flung areas, you know, to arrange that kind of infrastructure? In terms of human resource, also in terms of, you know, those instruments, let's say, be particular about music, how they can teach music to every student.
The NAP also has focused on permitting the schools to invite local music professionals, you know, to invite them as master teachers for short-term courses, whether it is a three-month course or a six-month course. This would allow the dying, you know, music, which is in our country, the remote forms of music,
folk music.
The folk music, yeah. Thank you, Jaswinderji. The folk music, you know, the dying form, this will be preserved. It will be passed on to the generations. And of course, I feel that there needs to be some kind of a framework which is defined. And looking at the online situation right now, I think music education can now become satellite. See, there are many courses. A child can sit at home and learn music even without having to buy an instrument. There are vocal courses like songwriting, singing, beatboxing, body percussion, home percussion. And we pioneered these courses, body and home percussion, in India during these lockdown times, because many of the children, they did not have any instrument at home. So we came up with these crazy ideas, and it is doing very well in all the schools where we are currently in. So I think the NEP already prescribes of these aspects, and a particular framework is required, which would you know, set the tone and properly inform the schools as to how they need to be going about teaching music across the country.
Thank you. Thank you, Sevio. With this, we come to the end of you know, 75th session. Before we formally conclude the session, I would request all our speakers, if we can have your concluding remarks. Also, you know, we have established one very interesting practice. While sharing your concluding remarks, I would also request if you can share, you know, one idea or one, you know, a suggestion. If you are given the charge of education, you know, of a country, if you become the Minister of Education, you know, of India, so what would be your that single day priority that you would like to implement at any cost? So I would request Manoj Sehgal sir, I would begin with you. If we can have your concluding remark, and what would you do as priority as Minister of Education, Manoj Sehgal sir?
Thank you so much. The first thing I would do is remove the entire paperwork required. Second, what I want is the examination system should become more student friendly. It is too much pressure right now for a student to score that much marks. I want that examination system to become more student friendly. In fact, maybe post 8th standard, the entire system should be multiple choice question, where he can have an open book. That's exactly what happens in IIT, or that happens in most of the American colleges also. You can keep a book, refer it, and then utilize it. So I want something, maybe not very early days, but yes, I want that system to come so the student is not scared or paranoid about examination. He starts enjoying it, starts enjoying what he learned, and he's able to implement it. That would be one change I really, if wish I could, I would want to do that. Thank you.
Absolutely, absolutely. In fact, during our last session, you know, one of our key speakers suggested that, you know, assessment should be there, that should be encouraged, but assessment should be without comparisons.
Exactly.
You know, so he also shared one very interesting example from Mahabharata, you know, how we can, you know, create that kind of entire system of assessing people. So now,
in fact, remember the Gurukul days, there was, they didn't have any pattern like that. There were no grades given to it. It's only the Britishers who got the grades of examination. And if you look at the Gurukul days, there was nothing like that. The teacher would decide okay, when is the student eligible to go to further grades. It's a British system which changes the entire scenario.
Then we had very, you know, less the teacher-student ratio, you know, how, like, when less number of students were coming for the education, but now we have that number. But again, certainly we can find some solutions around that. Thank you, Manoj sir. You know, I would request now, Sevio. Sevio, your concluding remark, and what would you do as Minister of Education? So we are giving you time, so we want you, you know, to share that very powerful thought as Minister of Education. So we'll come back to you at the last. So, Sevio.
One day as an education minister is too little, Rajanji. And there is hardly anything we should be able to achieve in that one day. But if I would get an opportunity like that, I would ensure, you know, that most of the subjects would become activity oriented, and there would be compulsory introduction of music and dance from the foundational level of the students.
Thank you. Yes, you said that it would be you know, very difficult to achieve something from that one day, but you know, there have been many education ministers who have spent 5 years but they could not achieve anything, you know. So don't worry about the achievements, you know, focus more upon the execution part. Thank you, Sevio. Jaswinder sir, over to you. What would be your concluding remark, and what would you do as Minister of Education?
Okay, so where am I? Okay, so when we talk about concluding remark, again getting onto languages, the more languages, the better a child is. One, okay, in our country this works better. So I would say focus on language, which they've rightly brought in. Very happy about it, strongly this thing. We should also include foreign languages. When you learn another foreign language, doesn't mean you've gone, you know, below them. You're learning somebody else's culture. Language brings in culture, right? So if you are able to get the best of things from other cultures, nothing like it. So that's how I would conclude my thing. But talking about me being a minister, I have got 2 points. First, I would say government should only be the policy makers. That's it, not the policy implementers. They should stay out of it. Okay. I'll give you another example. Let me give you an example of the IT industry. Okay. This came in long back. When the IT industry came into India, the government themselves didn't know anything about IT, right? So they let it grow by itself, and it grew leaps and bounds, right? Today, we are the best in the world. They did nothing, no regulations, right? And today that has worked. So I am sure education can work. And so many people thinking who are in the profession of education, that is better than one politician telling what to do. though this time NEP, they've got an educationist to do it. That's why we are seeing the difference. Okay. One more thing is what I'm now, you know, crusading for is we should make teachers the first citizens of a country. That respect. Professor Manoj, you were talking about Gurukul. वो तो माँ बाप की तरह थे रोज सुबह उठ के उनके पांव पड़ना उनके लिए पानी गर्म करना उनके लिए सब खेत में जाके यू टू गेट थिंग्स एंड देन यू स्टार्ट स्टडिंग राइट सो ऑलरेडी रिस्पेक्ट इज बिल्ट इन सो आई एम प्रपोजिंग समथिंग आई विल जस्ट टेक अ मिनट टू शो यू समथिंग ऑन द स्क्रीन एंड आई हैव चोजन दिस फोरम टू एक्चुअली वर्क ऑन दैट पार्ट आई एम ट्राइंग टू गेट अ विंडो ओके देयर नथिंग इज जस्ट ऑफिस कैन यू सी द स्क्रीन एवरीबॉडी
Yes, sir.
Can you see? So what I'm trying to say is, why can't we have ED written in front of an educator? If the doctors have that, if the engineers have that, if the chartered accountants have that, we've made them. So I am working on a project. I am going to talk to whichever, or whatever level I need to go, even if I have to go to the PMO. We have worked with Prime Minister Modi in Gujarat. We're trying to get it. Why not celebrate teacherhood, right? One teacher's day is not enough for us. We need every day. So I'm trying to get in there, and I would like to have support from all the people here, educationists. Let's ask our teachers and the educationists to write ED. Nobody's going to stop us from that. So this is what I would want to conclude my session with. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Jaspinder sir. This is a wonderful thought. You have our support and our votes as well. Thank you. Right. So with this, I would request Ravi ma'am, your concluding remark and what would be your idea as Minister of Education?
Well, the concluding remark is that we can encourage our students to create portfolio wherein every bit is included, that as a human being, as a student, what I have done. And that portfolio will be my identity as an individual, as a student, as a citizen of my India. And if this portfolio is encouraged, this portfolio system is encouraged, so definitely the kind of assessment will become a little more easy, a little more creative, and will be a little more above than simply mugging up and vomiting it out in a piece of paper and scoring good marks. And the other question, that is, if I would be the education minister for a day, I would first of all organize lot of orientation programs for the parents so that they become the active stakeholder and become a very active participant in the journey of their children's education. Because they simply bank upon institution. They say that I'm paying fees and that is more than sufficient. My job is done. And which is absolutely giving a very kind of a Herculean task on the part of a teacher, where the teacher is behaving like a parent, guardian, counselor, psychologist, and what not. And let's not overburden the teacher so that the teacher gets distracted for what he is being appointed for. And one message for the all the academicians, let's create pedagogical leader every day. Sitting on a chair in an AC room, let's not be a dictator. Rather, create a leader by giving opportunity to your team members, wherein they also learn, and in the days to come, they can also lead a team. Thank you so much from my end.
Wonderful, wonderful thought, ma'am. We need more collaborative approach, as you said, that certainly to execute the things. Thank you, ma'am. And also, after listening to your ideas, Minister of Education, I just got thing in my mind that a principal would always be a principal, you would always think that way, how we can, connect parents, how we can create more value for parents. So thank you, ma'am, for that, Ravi, ma'am. Now I would request Archana, ma'am. Your concluding remark and what would be your idea as Minister of Education? Archana ma'am.
Thank you. I would say that concluding remark would be see the positive side of NEP. Work on it. And even if there is a downside, try to bring it up so that in the, at the end of the day, it is the student, whether it is school education or higher education or whatever, the country progresses, our children progress. And the education minister thing, I would introduce a happiness curriculum. And for me, a happy mind is the most receptive. Be it a student, be it a teacher, be it the principal or the parent. And if our children are able to be happy, they will carry it home. Parents will be happy. And nobody should be able to abolish, after I am not the education minister, nobody should be able to abolish the happiness curriculum from the system. And especially because at this stage, the mental health is on a record low. So, and it applies to everybody. So people need to be happy to be able to be receptive for anything. Thank you.
Absolutely. Can I just comment?
Ma'am, Government of Delhi has introduced happiness curriculum, which has been even by UNICEF. They've said very good. I mean, they've given thumbs up to that. And it's a beautiful thing. I, in fact, a couple of years back, did a project with Government of Delhi training 12,000 students on language skills. And it was assessed by Trinity College London. Adding during that same time, they had introduced happiness curriculum. And I could see the change in kids. They would love to come to school and would not want to go back, because back home, it's again the same things. So yes, ma'am, happiness curriculum, something that we all look forward to, even at, adult level, today, yes. What things we go through, God only help us. Please, Rajulji, please.
Absolutely. We all agree with you, Archana ma'am. In fact, this corona period has taught us the value of happiness. Running after those materialistic things, we have learned we need just two, three simple things to live happily. Right. Big thanks to all of you. Big thanks, Archana ma'am, Ravi ma'am, Manoj sir, Jaswinder sir, N.K. Sharma sir, Mr. Savio John, for joining and making this 75th session of Leadership Talks truly special. Big thanks, all of you. So this was for the day. We'll end the session here. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you. It was great listening to
all. Pleasure to be with you all. Pleasure.
Thank you for inviting us.
Thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you and welcome. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.